welcome her tonight.
Amen. Thank you. Can you hear me okay?
Yes, we can.
Thank you. Thank you so much for allowing me to be a part of this. I'm so honored and blessed to connect with people from different places in the world and to build each other up. I have been blessed today listening to some of these powerful women of God speak what the Lord has laid on their heart. And I'm so blessed to be part of it and to speak to you today. As I was praying and asking the Lord about the topic that I was assigned on self-control and purity, I said, Lord, what does that mean? What does that mean? And so I believe being self-controlled is being obedient to the Holy Spirit. It's able to distinguish between what is the Spirit and what is my flesh, and knowing when to harness my flesh and when to yield to the Spirit. The Lord brought me to Judges chapter 4, to the story of Jael. And if you're not familiar with that story, it's the woman who was used of God to slay the enemy with a tent peg and a hammer. And I thought about this story and I said, Lord, how does this demonstrate self-control? And so I said, it's a demonstration of her obedience to the Spirit and her willingness to step out and to do what the Spirit asked her to do. And so, you know, I thought about JL. She was a housewife. She was a tent dweller. She was basically a housewife. And the weapons that she used, a tent peg and a hammer, she had probably held these things in her hand thousands of times as she pounded them into the ground to secure her tent that she dwelt in. And the very thing that she held in her hand thousands of times, one day when she picked them up, when the enemy came to her door, it became a weapon. And so that old familiar object became a weapon in her hand with the power of the Holy Spirit. And so when you demonstrate self-control and you are yielding to the Spirit, the things that are in your hand become weapons, things that you never knew were there, things that you didn't even realize that you possessed within you. God says, look at your hand. I have placed them in your hand. You don't realize the power and the might that you have within you that I have placed in you. My mom used to bake bread and she would use that as a tool. She would go to people's homes and she would give them bread and she would pray for them and she could minister to them. She used the talent that she had, the gift that she had, she used it to build the kingdom of God. In Judges 4, 21, it says, then Jael, Heber's wife, took a tent peg and took a hammer in her hand and went softly to him and drove the peg into his temple, and it went down into the ground, for he was fast asleep and weary. When I read that, I heard the Lord say that the enemy has underestimated many people today, many men and many women. He has grown sleepy and he has grown weary because he doesn't see you as a threat. He has tried to lock us in our homes, thinking that he has stopped us, thinking that that he can contain us, but he has only managed to make us stronger. He has only succeeded in playing right into God's hands by placing you in a position where you are going to step into God's destiny for your life. Just like JL with Sisera. Sisera fell asleep in JL's presence because he didn't see her as a threat. The enemy isn't afraid of who you are right now. He's afraid of who you are going to be when you realize that you are not just holding a tent peg and a hammer, you are holding a weapon for the kingdom of God. And when you begin to wield those weapons for the kingdom of God, you are going to not only take down the enemy, but you are going to rise up and raise others up with you to do the same thing that you are doing. Judges 4:9 says, this is Deborah speaking, and she says, I will go with you. Nevertheless, there will be no glory for you in the journey you are taking, for the Lord will sell Sisera into the hand of a woman. I feel like there are some women that need to hear today that they are God's solution. Barak denied God's assignment. God's solution to that denial was Jael. There are women that are listening to this right now that need to hear they are God's solution. They are not the problem. They are God's solution. They are not the problem. What a powerful thought. The enemy has come up against Israel and all hope seems lost. Their hero has abandoned the call. And I can almost hear God saying, don't worry, I've got JL. She doesn't realize how fierce and mighty she is. However, she is self-controlled. She yields to the Spirit and wait until she picks up that tent peg. Wait until she picks up that hammer. The enemy's not going to know what hit him. It's time for the JLs in this world to rise up, the modern day JLs. It's time for this generation of women to pick up our tent pegs, pick up our hammers, and get to work. We are God's secret women. We are God's secret weapons. We are the solution to the problem. We are the battle plan. And when we join together with the men and with other women, and we step into that, God will be able to do great and powerful things. Judges 4:2 says, so the Lord sold them into the hand of Jabin, the king. God strategically placed Jael where she was so that he might be used of her, or she might be used of him. Israel was sold into the hand of Jabin. Yes, Israel sinned, but it was God's divine intervention. It was his strategy that placed them there under Jabin. Israel didn't go to war on purpose. Jabin came up against Israel on his own. God intentionally handed them over. And so this caused me to think, how many times has God intentionally placed me in situations so that I would cry out to him? Have I yielded to the Spirit? Have I demonstrated self-control so that when God puts me in these situations, that I will rise up and I will do what God has asked me to do, that I won't back down? We don't have to understand the plan of God in order to trust it. Because if we looked at God's plan, we might think that God is crazy. This can't possibly be what you have for me, God. This can't possibly be your solution. And yet here it is. This is what God determined. God knew Barak wouldn't fulfill all that he was called to do. And he intentionally placed Jael in a position so that he might use her to bring forth the victory. And so my question to you today is, will you be ready when the time comes for God to use you? Are you going to walk in self-discipline, in self-control, so that you can hear the Spirit of God? So when the enemy knocks on your door, you will be able to pick up your hammer and your tent peg, and you will be able to slay the enemy. Often we become discouraged because of our circumstances. And my greatest fear today for women is that they will get lost in their circumstances and their situations, and they won't be ready when they are called into action. Jael was hidden. She was in an obscure place, as many of us are hidden away in our homes in an obscure place. And God is saying, don't despise those days of obscurity. These days are what's going to propel you into the open and into your destiny. God is calling us out of a time, out of those hidden and obscure places. And are we prepared so that when the doors open, are we going to come out fighting as God intended us to do? Jael didn't leave the area that God placed her in. She recognized her boundaries. Recognizing where God has placed you is another tool, another key point to being self-controlled. She held her place until God said it was time. She didn't go beyond her borders when she wasn't called to do so. She respected where she was placed, and she didn't allow that to limit her. I've seen a lot of women who have an attitude of, I want to be seen, I want to be heard, I want to be known, and they have gone outside of the realm that God has called them to because they are seeking a position and they are seeking a path that will bring them fame instead of doing what God has called them to do. And so being self-controlled is pulling back on those desires, my personal wants, my personal desires, and being obedient to the Holy Spirit. God is going to place us and position us somewhere, and he's going to bring someone in your path that will cause you to either step into your destiny or deny it. Sisera fled to Jael's door. God led him right to her. Talk about, you know, when opportunity knocks, this is a saying that we have, when opportunity knocks, what will you do when that opportunity knocks for you? Are you going to be self-controlled and disciplined and hear that Spirit and know it's time to act? It's time to respond to the Spirit. You don't need a platform. You don't need an audience to be fierce in the kingdom of God. No one knew Jael. No one knew what she was capable of. No one saw her defeat the enemy except for God. And that's all that matters. Often the most powerful things that we can do will be done in private. in the security and privacy of our own homes. And that's okay. We don't have to be out in front of people. We don't have to be out there to be a powerful tool and a weapon for God. Be who he called you to be. Be what he called you to be. Your value and your worth and your identity aren't tied to your position or your title. It's tied to the one who saved you. And don't despise where God has placed you, but most of all, don't waste the opportunity where God has placed you. I came across a story of a man who's from India. His name was Dashrath Manji. And this man single-handedly carved a road in the mountain. His wife was injured one day, and unfortunately, she died from her injuries because the journey from his village, his remote village, to the hospital was too far. He had to go around a mountain, and so his wife died on the journey. So Dashrath decided that he was going to carve a road through the mountain so that no one would ever have to face what he had to face. And all Dashrath had was a little hammer and a chisel, and it took him 22 years, but he carved a road through the mountain. Now, Manji could have looked at that mountain and allowed it to conquer him and said, this could never be done. Instead, he attacked the mountain little by little until he broke through the mountain. Don't allow the enemy to convince you that your dream is dead. Don't allow the enemy to convince you that your mountain cannot be removed. Pick up your hammer, pick up your chisel, and go to work for the kingdom of God. Keep pounding away until you see light on the other side of the mountain. The mountain man used what was in his hand. He only saw a little result every day, but his efforts, what he did with his hammer and his chisel, changed the lives of the people in that village for generations to come. What you and I have the ability to do today can be life-altering for generations to come. When we maintain our self-control, when we yield to the Spirit, when God says, act now, and we do, we are changing the lives of those that will come behind us. There are people now that Manji is long gone, but there are people now that walk through the mountain that he carved with his bare hands. What are people going to walk through behind you that are coming behind you that you are going to carve a path for? What do you have the ability to do in the Spirit as you yield to the Spirit and you deny self? And what are you going to have the ability to do for generations and generations to come? You are making those choices and decisions now, and it's time to step into those things that will have ramifications for your family for generations. And so I hear the Lord say, I've heard him say many times, it's time. The Lord says it's time. It's time for women to rise up. It's time for men to rise up in Jesus' name. It's time to pick up our hammers. It's time to pick up our tent pegs and our chisels. It's time to take what we have in our hands and run to the mountain and begin to attack it. God is calling forth modern day JLs, modern day men and women that will not stand and allow the enemy to defeat them, that they will take what God has placed in their hands and they will use it for his kingdom. He's looking for those that will be afraid, but will fight anyway. You and I are the JLs that God is looking for. And will you step forth? Will you control the flesh? Will you step out in the Spirit? Will you take the mountain? Will you transform the mountain? Hallelujah. Thank you again for allowing me to be a part of this. And I pray that you will be touched and that you will rise up and use what God has placed in your hand to further the kingdom of God. Amen. Thank you. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Wow.